I'm using Da Vinci's Vitruvian Man as a symbol of representing our anthropic reach, if you will. And last time, and I'm using size horizontally at the bottom, large being to the on the right side of the diagram, small being at the left. And last time we explored bigness and largeness, if you will, and astronomy, astrophysics, the universe. That's we talked about that a little bit last time. The main discovery on the largeness side was that the universe is finite. It's not infinite. And that's the biggest discovery of 20th century science. It might be expanding, but it's finite. And that's a shock. And we demonstrated how we know it is last time. I won't go through that all again. So this time we're going to go the other way. We're going to explore smallness, okay? And this is going to plunge us into the study of what's called quantum physics, subatomic particles. And we're going to study smallness. And it also is astonishingly finite. And that's going to be more mysterious to us than the fact that the universe is finite. And we'll go into this here. We discover that everything, length, mass, energy, time itself, are composed of indivisible units called quanta. And I want to demonstrate what that means. Let's back up a minute, though. When we were in school, we probably indulged in one of the models of an atom. The typical one, we'll use hydrogen, the simplest atom. It's got a nucleus and it's got an electron energy level around it. And the nucleus in the center, the electrons on the outside. Now, this is obviously not to scale, okay? If we were to build a scale model of this electron, or this atom, hydrogen atom, and we used a golf ball to represent the nucleus, the electron that we'd have spinning around it would be 3 football fields away. Okay? Just to give you a flavor of this thing. Now, we know that the atom itself is in the neighborhood of 10 to the minus 8 centimeters. 0.00008 It's a very, very tiny part of a centimeter. Okay? The nucleus of that, that's the whole atom. The nucleus is 10 to the minus 13 centimeters, much smaller, 13 zeros, okay? The important part isn't the absolute number. They're obviously very small. The important thing is the ratio between them. In other words, whatever the nucleus is, the electron is 100,000 times that size in radius. You follow me so far? That's linear. 10 to the fifth. 10 to the fifth, that's 100,000. Bear with me here. If I make the nucleus a golf ball, okay, the electron is, I said football field, 3 miles away, right? 3 miles away. So if we were going to build a model, we have an ambitious project, if we make the nucleus as big as a golf ball, our electron has to be 3 miles away. That's just the linear distance. Follow me through. That doesn't talk about the area that it goes. What do I do to get the area? I square it, don't I? Right? So if the area ratio then would be 10 to the fifth times 10 to the fifth, or another way of saying it, 10 to the fifth squared, or 10 to the tenth, the area. Except the molecule isn't planar, it's three-dimensional, isn't it? So we have to go a third dimension, so we have to have the volumetric ratio. It would be 10 to the fifth times 10 to the fifth times 10 to the fifth, or put it another way, 10 to the cube. Or 10 to the 15th. You say, well, what do all these numbers have to do? I just wanted to get you a flavor of what we're dealing with here, is that if I have a model of an atom, the ratio of the part that's solid, so to speak, the nucleus, to the volume that it represents as an energy field and so forth, has a ratio of one part to 10 to the 15th, volumetrically. Are we together so far? Let me dramatize what that may mean to you. That has the same ratio as 1 second does to 30 million years. So if I said that, let's just use this podium as an example. If I said this podium is solid, and one of you said there's nothing here at all, it's empty, you're more correct than I am by the same ratio. Okay? The solidness here has the same ratio to the podium itself as 1 second has to 30 million years. Why does it feel solid? Because the atoms here are an electrical collision with the atoms of my hand, so it feels solid. you follow me? It has all those physical properties, but it's really accrues because of an electrical simulation. Okay, the electrons are negative. It's the collision of those molecules that create the appearance of it being solid. But it's mostly empty. What do you mean mostly? Well, that ratio, 1 second to 30 million years. That sounds, do the math sometime. It's astonishing. So that is this, is it empty space? See, conjecture two is more descriptive than one by the same ratio. It's more empty space than solid by a ratio of 1 second to 30 million years. And so that's, I want you to get a feeling for this illusion that we call solidity, if you will. Now, what we discover as we start examining things, we discover that everything we run into is made up of indivisible units. Now, what do I mean by that? Let's assume I have a piece of string that's of whatever length you choose. I can cut that in half, obviously, and end up with half of what I had, right? No problem. I can take what's left and cut that in half, right? And do that again. And I can keep doing that, and you would think that I can keep doing that. It might get so small that I can't really do it. It's not empty, but it conceptually, whatever I have left over, you figure I can cut in half, right? Wrong. It turns out I can keep doing that until I get to a distance of 10 to the minus 33 centimeters. And then I discover if I try to cut that in half, that thing is throughout the entire universe at the same instant. It loses a property that physicists call locality. It is no longer local. And they actually prove this in a laboratory experiment, that every photon knows is connected with every other photon in the universe immediately, faster than the speed of light. And that shatters many fundamental concepts in physics. It turns out, I've described it here in terms of length, it's also true of time. Time is made up of units. 10 to the minus 43 seconds is the unit of time. There is no unit of time smaller than that. It's very small, but there's nothing smaller than that. That's a unit of time. There's units of length, mass, energy, and time. The example is, you know, on a violin, you can get any tone you want by where you fret it, right? It's variable. A piano gives you only the keys that you hit. You can look at it in that sense, it's digital. We discover the universe is digital. And that turns out to have some profound significance. There are two concepts that we can talk about in mathematics, but we discover don't show up in the universe. One is randomness, and the other one is infinity. Those are terms we use a lot. The infinity in the macrocosm would say that we have a universe that's infinite, except we know that we have a finite universe. There is no infinity in astronomy. We can talk about it mathematically. We can't find it physically on the big side. The shock is that we can't find it on the small side either.